Hello everyone, how are you? Hope you all are healthy and safe. Myself, Bhupesh Sharma, and I am going to teach you chemistry. So let us discuss our today's topic. So today's topic is rate of chemical reaction. Dear students, everyday experiences shows that the chemical reactions takes place in different rates. Some reactions are very fast. When the reactant combine with each other, we can get a product. For example, the ionic equations. Ionic equations, we can get a product as soon as the reactant combine with each other. Let us take the example, silver nitrate combines with sodium chloride. As soon as silver nitrate combines with sodium chloride, we can get a product. Same as in neutralization reactions. What is the neutralization reaction? We all know the reaction of acid and base are known as neutralization reaction. So neutralization reactions are also very fast. As soon as the reactant combines with each other, we can get a product. Okay. Now, students, few reactions are there which are very slow. For example, the rusting of iron. We all aware about the rusting of iron. This reaction is very slow. And we can easily determine its rate. Okay. Now question is, what is rate? So dear student, rate is a speed. Speed. It is a speed of the reaction. How much time reactant takes to convert into the product is known as rate of reaction. Understood? How we define the rate of reaction? It is defined as the rate of change of concentration of reactants and products with time. Okay, or you can say that decrease in the concentration of reactant with time, the increase in the concentration of product with time. So rate of chemical reaction is defined as change in concentration upon time taken is known as the rate of reaction. So, suppose we have one reaction, general reaction R, it gives product. Reactant combines and gives a product. So, rate of this reaction is expressed as minus delta concentration of R divided by delta T. What is delta? It shows the change in concentration. What is the initial concentration and what is the final concentration? It shows the difference. Suppose R has an initial concentration R1 and final concentration R2. Okay. Delta R is equal to R2 minus R1. Same as delta T is equal to T2 minus T1. What is T2? T2 is the time, initial time and final time. T1 is initial time and T2 final time when we get a product. Okay. So in this way we can express the rate of reaction. This is a reactant, and if we want to express product, we can write delta P upon delta T. Okay. Now see here. Here is a positive and it is a negative. Reactant's rate is negative and product rate is positive. What it means? So dear student, we know that the concentration of reactant always decrease and concentration of product always increase in the chemical reaction. So due to this reason, we apply minus here. Understood? Now we take any other example. One more example we have to take. Suppose PCl5. It gives PCl3 plus Cl2. Now we want to express rate of this reaction. Rate of reaction is equal to minus delta concentration of PCl5 divided by delta T is equal to delta concentration of PCl3 upon delta T is equal to delta concentration of Cl2 chlorine upon delta T. So beta, in this way we can express the rate of any reaction. Understood? Suppose we have a general reaction A plus B 2C. We want to express the rate of this reaction. Okay. So here we have a coefficient of C. So rate of this reaction is expressed as minus delta A upon delta T is equal to minus delta B upon delta T. Now see, this one is equal to 1 by 2 delta C upon delta T. So write the coefficient in this way, 1 upon. Okay. Suppose here we have a 3, then we can write here 1/3. If we have 4, then we can write 1/4. If we have 5, then we can write 1/5. Understood? We are going to discuss the unit of rate of reaction. So what is the unit of rate of reaction? As we discussed, rate of reaction is equal to concentration change in concentration divided by time taken. Change in concentration divided by time taken. Now the unit of concentration per liter and unit of time is second minute. Okay. So what is the unit of rate of reaction? Unit of rate of reaction becomes moles liter inverse second inverse. So you have to remind these units. So today we discussed about the rate of reaction and its unit. Thank you. Have a nice day.